Everybody, this is Victa. 17 Eaton Street here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. As you can see down below, obviously there's been an addition to the Like Street counter, something that we talked about a little while ago in the Plus Ultra Ludicrous streak. If we happen to somehow cross that many likes on the videos, we'll keep track of it. And if it happens, then yes, I will agree to do a blind items week challenge where we take nothing but blind items if we do get Curse the Blind. So there you go. It's now the gauntlet has been thrown down, and now it's time for the mosh pit to step up and see if that's actually going to happen or not. Not doubting the mosh pit, but that's quite the feat, although I think it could be done. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you 27 days ago by Verizan. Title thread was, Do I look like I know what a missing no is? Those kids had taken blind items, they'd be very upset. Yes, missing no. Thank you, Bobby, and thank you, Hank, and to Verizan, all 423 of you who upvoted that one 27 days ago. We're just resurrecting old memes of the day. See, today is going to be 8 Hef, 3 Nintendo 64s. We've got the Leech, and now we don't. We got Rainbow Babby and Great Hair to start off the run today. We also have the D1 Hizzle, of course. D100 is going to re-roll Isaac as well as do the D... Well, basically, it's the D6, the D4, and the D20 all in one. So it re-rolls Isaac, it re-rolls everything on the ground, and it also re-rolls any item pedestals that happen to be present. Now, is the D100 a very good item? Yes, it is. Are we going to use it on every cooldown? Yeah, probably, until we get something better. That's about all I can say. Now, obviously, with us having no idea how much HP we have, we got to be very careful about Mega Troll Bombs like the one that we saw in this room here. Infestation 2 is not a bad item to start with, but we'll most likely re-roll unless we get something baller on this floor. Yeah, of course, another Tinted Rock there, but we don't have a bomb, so. But yeah, it's, the D100 runs have always proven to be pretty popular on YouTube just because of just the absolute zaniness that can occur. And, I'm not above some zane. I ain't above a level of zane. I'm pretty sure. Well, no, the secret room may not be there. It's probably to the left of there. Super secret room is over there, and actually, no, the secret room is not there. So I have a sneaky suspicion that it is here, and it just barely missed the radius of the explosion. But what can you do? Gonna be Larry Jr. So if you find yourself tasked with the idea, or at least with maybe not tasked, but if you find yourself with the ability to re-roll your run, how often should you, and when, and basically when should you stop? You should definitely quit while you're ahead because it can get out of control. But for right now, we've got lots of HP and lots of re-rolling opportunity. Yeah, so tons of HP here thanks to the PJs. But we also started with a whole bunch of HP as well on top of that single soul heart that we got earlier. And now we've got triple shot, juicy sack. And we got lunch as well. Not terribly great because obviously we lost a lot of tiers rate, but it could potentially be good, question mark. We just have to find out what's in our item room first. So right now our goal is to just simply get into the item room and see what we got going on. Of course, this is still part of No Shop Till Dono Week, which will be lasting all the way until Sunday's run, ending on Sunday's run. So like Sunday's run will feature No Shop Till Dono Week. And then after that, we go back to normal. But the Plus Ultra Like Street goal, man, that's something that I talked about a couple of months ago and decided that now's the time. We're hitting the January, February lulls in terms of YouTube stuff, and we definitely need something to spur the growth of the channel. Not only that, but of course, just to kind of hype things up, get ready for the summertime and all that kind of. Well, I mean, we got to get ready for spring first, but. Oh, wow. Black bean, really? For me? So just golly gee willikers good. Also, there are three locked rooms on this floor. Not one, not two, but three, if we're not including the item room, which we're not. Okay. A golden key would be amazing right now if we can get one of those, but not going to happen. I was also kind of just looking for a full charge. Thank you. Satanic Bibble. Book of Sizzle, and we're going to take the Bizzle, and we're going to take the Batterer Hizzle, and we're going to re-roll the Librizzle. We got the Pentagram. Ooh, Ooh, these are some tasty stats. Going to get the Bookworm transformation as well as the Book of Revelations, which should hook us up with giving us an orbital on the boss if this were floor number one, which it's not. But yeah, that wasn't too bad. We are going to get an orbital. Well, that's fantastic. So this is a great start right here, starting with the screw and the pentagram, as well as getting an orbital. You know, we can stop now while we're way ahead. I was thinking about saving the D100 for the devil deal, but I mean, this is just, we're in pretty good here. I think we can go back and get a key. We may be able to go into the store to donate a little bit. Oh, I didn't have to do. I could have used Bob's Rotten Head. We could take Bob's Rotten Head over the D100. That's not a bad idea. And once again, we don't have a donation machine to start with. No, we'll hold on to the D100. Will we hold on to the run that we're on currently? We should, but will we? I don't know. Let's see how this run progresses. And be Envy. It's also known as Hutz's room. Now, had Envy dropped Shoop to Whoop, I definitely would have taken it over the D100 at this point. With our damage being far, far, far over what is considered par for the course right now. I saw that super jump. And try to mask that game. Ain't got no Yaves. Wait, wasn't there just a key that dropped, or is it inaccessible? No, okay. I was gonna say, wait a second. You got Yaves right there. They reroll Charm of the Vampire. If we get something like just balling out of control here, then we'll definitely stick with the. We'll probably stop rerolling. Yeah, we've had enough of Loki's horns for now. But yeah, going back to the original hypothetical question that I brought up earlier in this episode, you know, when is a good time? How do you know when to stop rerolling? It really comes down to personal preference and like what kind of run you think that you're having. Like if the writing's on the wall and the troll engine's out in full force, you know, then maybe you should stop while you're ahead. You know, are you better? Just ask yourself this question. Did the D100 make my run better? If the answer is yes, and you don't, and then you have to ask the second question. So if yes, would I be bad or would I be sad if I ended up getting something that was worse than this run that I rolled now? If the answer is yes, then you need to stop. We have the box, which produced a whole bunch of consumables on the ground. Then the D100 re-rolled that, so pretty good. And yes, I just now realized that the box also gave us some money and some bombs, so I could have gone back and re-rolled the item room, but failed to remember that in time. I had already acted upon going to the next floor. You know. So we end up re-rolling that run, which, I mean, re-rolling that run right there was not the best move, I would say. But I'm also doing it just because, I don't know, we're feeling spicy today. Definitely could use some spice today. I've had a not so great day outside of work and everything. So let's try to bring a little excitement to our lives here. It's a Saturday. We've got the plus ultra like streak goal. The gauntlet has been thrown down to the mosh pit. We'll see how they respond. I learned a long time ago. People learned a long time ago that you really shouldn't count out the mosh pit whenever it comes to challenges. We get another non-donation. This might be the greatest streak I've ever seen of not getting a donation machine when we actually want one. you know, like the one time where we're like, we don't want a reroll machine, we want a donation machine. Game's like, no, I don't think I'm going to do that. Whatever that meme is. We have fish head here. And two hearts. We're going to drop the two hearts and re-roll. Okay, had I taken experimental treatment, we would have gotten spun. We have dry baby, growth hormones, little Steven, Jesus juice, and blood clot. We still maintain the cube of meat, by the way, which I'm not at this point sure how that's possible, but I'll gladly take it. Hi, baby. There we go. I had to pull off that one bomb fly. It was one shot from being destroyed. We don't want it to blow up right in our face. It's always best when you can use the bomb flies against the other bomb flies. That's the goal in that room. Okay, we have a reroll. I'm gonna save it for the devil deal, though. Wow, our movement speed is pretty high right now. But we are getting a good amount of money here, so assuming that we actually do get a reroll or a donation machine instead of a reroll machine, then we gonna be sitting pretty. Because then we can start, you know, obviously donating to the shop, and then eventually unlock the shop for our goods and services needs. All right, see who we got. It's going to be Stain. Shouldn't be a big deal here, especially with an orbital. Now, I thought I was standing behind Dry Baby there, but apparently not. And we got a movement speed upgrade, so we're going to go ahead and yeet. We get Magic Mushroom. Now, that's what I'm talking about. We're not going to take another HP because we're running out of Soul Hearts. We'll just head on down. Soul Heart slots, I should say. You know what? I don't think I will. So now we have a Magic Mush and Blue Cap, which is the reason why our and stem cell as well, which is the reason why that our shot speed is so good and our tears rate is so good. So again, this one, especially with Magic Mush, this one contends for. We should probably stick with it, but. Again, for me, part of the problem with sticking with runs is that, like, it's like, yeah, but we could get something better, we could get something worse, we don't know. The thing is right now is that we don't really have enough items that we've seen that would make that much of a difference with us rerolling. So what I mean by that is that because the base amount of items that we're getting is a very limited amount of pools. And because of this, we can literally only go one way. Because of this, we're getting disproportionately good items and good starting stats for where we would normally be. So in other words, there's plenty of places that we can catch up with these stats again, if just by simply going through the motion of re-rolling stuff. Our stats are relatively going to fluctuate between very, very good and, you know, pretty good. I'm getting spun here thanks to the D1 Hizzle. And a mapping would be nice as well. Max out tier delay thanks to Horn Photo. And Halo as well. I mean, Halo helped out quite a bit. And Mr. Dolly. We're getting all the premier items that we would want to have without actually getting them from bosses and stuff. Like, this is another solid base entry level for a run. Well, found the store. Will there be a donation machine in here? We know it can't be a greed fight because we fought Gluttony on this run. On this room, I should say. So, show me the donation machine, coach. They've done it. Alright, it's been locked. Good, good, good. The Cat of Nine Tails, Rib of Greed. Our damage is even better here thanks to Cat of Nine Tails. Movement speed did go down quite a bit. Oh yeah. Still looking for the item room. You see here the difference that Bookworm makes in your DPS as well. Even one little proc shot here and there can very greatly increase the amount of DPS that you can do. Here we got now just runes. Gonna be great for bosses that we have trouble with. I'll pick up Bum Friend only because I'm just gonna serve as reroll fodder, and we need some more passive items. Now, there's another determining factor in when you should and shouldn't reroll, and that's gonna be the quality of your devil deals. You know, do you really want to reroll Brimstone into a normal item? No. Answer is no. Even if you think it's not no, it's no. But if you get a bunch of, like, say, not so great devil deal items and you still kind of want to have a chance to win, then, like, you know, you should. Actually, we should take the wooden cross because we have no soul hearts right now. Which means if we get touched once, then we lose our devil deal. In fact, I'm going to even use the Algis rune just to make sure that didn't happen. Get basic HP, get the Pact, and Headless Baby. The Pact is fantastic. Headless Baby is not. But we're going to re-roll it anyway. Ooh, Anti-Grav Tears. We don't want any more HP. We got Anti-Grav, Incubus, Leviathan Transformation, Death's List. Not sure what that item does. So we could get the 9-volt. The 9-volt will give us a full charge and also allow us to reroll again. And we can reroll the HP that the boss dropped. Or reroll the item inside of the mob trap room, but let's go in here. And we say, all right, slowed us down quite a bit. Our damage is still very good, thanks to Spun. Virgo is going to give us some pill neutrality and pill positivity, and we'll head on down. All right, now one thing we do have to be careful of, again, and this is the hazards. This is one of the hazards about rerolling all the time, is that we have too much. We have too much red heart HP, which means that we don't have any buffer zone, any defense for our devil deal in terms of soul hearts, because we do not have enough capacity for it. So that's a problem. Again, you're more apt to get HP upgrades because there's a zillion, billion, bajillion of them in this game than you are other items that, like, you know, actually matter most of the time. So what we try to do here is we try to limit the amount of HP that we can get and just pray that we end up getting something good that's associated with, like, 3 HP upgrades. Because we don't want to have a full rack of red hearts, because that what happens then is that it doesn't matter how powerful your run is. If you get touched once by either you being distracted or if you're just being lazy or whatever, or if you get legitimately hit by something, your devil deal is just gone. And we've talked about how important getting the devil deal is on every single floor. It is the most important thing that you can do. That's what you should be striving. Because not only does striving for devil deals as your main as your main source of motivation to not get hit helps you, because obviously the devil deal, but it also enables you to play better because you have something to fight for. It allows you to make smart decisions. Do we prioritize using this bomb trying to find the secret room that may not have a soul heart, or do we just go for the gusto and go straight towards the source, you know, sort of thing. And that kind of, you know, that kind of attitude with Isaac will always improve your play. It's like, yeah, we're going to have to buckle down and hunker down and get this devil deal, otherwise we're in a lot of trouble. Wow, that random champion shot. Okay, game. Okay. Apple's gonna be a tears up, but get Tech X. Money Goes Power, Holy Light. Oh yeah. Robo Baby 1.0. And obviously Tech X is a huge, huge item for us to get. And we can use the store, and the final store is a greed fight. Oh yeah, we have Money Equals Power. I could go back and pick up that money. I should go back and pick up that money. That's what YouTube wants me to do. YouTube also asks me to do a lot of things that I don't do and I don't want to do. Let's see if we get a payout here. I mean, Gimpy, not exactly the best item for us. Bombs are key. I can see forever. Pick up this money here just because we have Money Goes Power, so we might as well get some money. And people can stop yelling at me, you should go back, stop being lazy. Rawr. Want to use Arrowwalk? I think Arrowwalk is a slow. Gonna blow it up just so we can maybe get some money. Victor, you have Lucky Rock. You can just go bomb everything to Victor. Yeah, but I don't want to use all our bombs. And we're also going to reroll this anyway. So, yeah. Good luck upgrade. But remember, the pill upgrades are permanent. And it goes for smelted trinkets as well. We don't have, but it would be nice if we did. All right. Not pass our 9% deal with the devil. No surprise there. Reroll, we get conjoined soy milk. Terrific. And this is what would be considered as a not great reroll. We'll head on down. Yeah. All right, so we are pretty much done with devil deals for the rest of this run, because there's no way that we're going to be able to defend ourselves with this little amount of damage. Just let me out of here. I'm not even sure if we have Serpent's Kiss or if that's a Scorpio or not. Okay, Serpent's Kiss. Again, we can't get rid of all these red hearts. I mean, if we wanted to or tried. The rock over here is not really going to make a difference. All right, working with a 23% deal with the devil. I don't know what hit me over here. Oh, we have Fire Mind. I wonder. I was like, why are things exploding? We have either Fire Mind or we have $3 bill. It's one of those. or nothing? Do we have number two? No. Not sure what was exploding over there that was hurting me. Health down, we'll take. It may seem counterintuitive, but remember, we can at least take a soul heart. That will prevent us from taking red heart damage temporarily. Little Brimmy putting in some work tonight. I like it. I like the hustle, son. That's what I'm talking about. Gonna have a reroll for the possible devil deal, which again I'm not gonna hold my breath at this point. I probably will have to use the Arawak card on the boss. See, it looks like we also have like sulfuric acid tears because we're breaking open the doors and we're not even hitting them. So I'm not sure what this run is, but I don't like it. It doesn't get any worse than Tech 2. Oh, thanks. There's a bomb rock right next to the door. That was cool. It doesn't get any worse than Tech 2 into soy milk. Wow. I got hit trying to get the black soul art and Arawak slow to blastocyst, right? Well, at least we have the D100 to keep us company. E1 Hizzle, what say you? Pretty trash. Pretty trash. So yeah, no more devil deals. At least we don't have soy milk anymore, but we do have marked. And that's bad. We also have skinny on mushroom, which is also affecting our stats. So also have God's flesh. Really wish that Liberty Cap or something had dropped down so we can at least see where we're not supposed to go. God's flesh, by the way, will turn anything that you hit into a miniature that you can walk over and instantly kill. Marked, by the way, is that little, it's hard to see because it's Curse of the Darkness, but that little aiming reticule there, that will keep Isaac firing in that direction, but you can't do anything about in terms of like when you fire, you're always firing. However, it is very, very good when you combine Marked with Cursed Eye. That was one of the premier combos that you could get back in the day that really made it worthwhile to go after. Yeah, so let's see, are we close to the boss or not? Yeah, back in the day, you would want Marked and Cursed Eye, which I mean, it still does work. I just haven't had it in a while. If I see the guillotine, we immediately know this one ain't for me. We'll have our Yara rune. Got Beelzebub, Amalacria, Death's Touch, and a whole lot of empty space on the map. Yeah, so this would be pretty good if we had a faster tiers rate, but as you're seeing here, we are quite literally one-shotting these rooms. Great card. I think we'll hold on to the error room. And dead end. By the way, the and a dead end. All right. And we got Judas's freaking shadow. We might as well just change it to him now. I don't know if we also have Goathead. We might. Pretty sure I've taken damage already. We don't want to reroll until we're Black Judas. Because at least at the bare minimum, no matter what can happen, we're still, at the end of the day, Black Judas. Malacria doing the lob shot here. Yeah, conjoined is where the triple shot came from. And it's generally considered not all that great because it basically dropped your damage. And I don't want to have part of my damage. I want to have all my damage. It's very relatable with taxes coming up. I don't want to have 60% of my income. I want 100% of my income. Oh, we have shielded tears as well. You get a double deal here. And the final devil deal is a not devil deal, devil deal. All right. So we're going to purposely turn into Black Judas here. And then we'll reroll. There's no reason for us to go back into the devil deal. And now we can go back and get that soul heart. Could reroll in there as well. Yeah, but now 22.58 damage is real nice. Oh, that Coach Grendor. Speaking of which, we have that best of five show match coming up today in the 2 o'clock slot. Me versus Coach Krendor in a best of five for Battleship. So don't miss that. I'm glad that people have been enjoying that game because it is a lot of fun to play. You should try to play it too. Dark Bum. Here we go. One and done today, son. He literally threw out a hostile spider at the very beginning. First thing he did. Let's go. Ooh. Oh. I take that excited ooh back. We got Tiny Planet, Tech Point 5. Pop Eden's Blessing, so that means that we're going to have an extra item on tomorrow's run. Parasitoid, which is great. Yeah, this is just a mess of things here. Now, whenever you have pop and you have a high amount of shot speed, you're in a decent amount of shot speed, it can start, basically its movement speed will start multiplying on itself and will just get faster and faster and faster until you have to require an epilepsy warning on your video. And another dead end. Game is just having too much fun watching us reroll all these great runs. Of Cursed Eye, yeah. Jacob's Ladder, oh my goodness. What in the world? If Jacob's Ladder, Tractor Beam. Okay, this is really odd because you don't normally see Lacrimogy mixed with Tractor Beam. Jacob's Ladder is huge for this build too. That's a lot of DPS. And we're gonna reroll just cause we can. X zero, which is actually, it makes conjoined pretty good. Tech Zero. We do have Strange Attractor, Acid Baby, Demon Baby, the whole nine yards. They're all here. Something to Smash Brothers. Should go get that key. But we do have a Yara rune here. So again, obviously we're gonna use that on the chest. in the chest, however you decide to be in the chest. Oh, Isaac just now, he just now started reacting to a strange attractor. Yeah, this is why you don't want strange attractor ever. Ever. Ever, ever, ever. It's bad. It's real bad. It is funny watching them fly around and glitch out all over the place, but it's not funny whenever you're like, you have no life and every shot that you shoot makes them faster, like moving towards you. That's a Zodiac, I think. Maybe. That's just Rags. We got the mind. Nerd. Ooh, this could be spicy here. I'm going to take Lazarus's Rags just in case, and then we're going to... Well, we need to clear one. There's no full charge here. To say... How you doing, Sissy? Here we go, little Sissy. We don't need nothing else. Let's roll. Little Sissy coming to save the day. Oh, apparently we also have Nodleaf, which I didn't realize till just now. Go get him, Sissy. See, our damage is nowhere near as good as it was on some of the other runs, but we have Sissy, so who cares? That's a little bit dicey to come in here with not really a great setup, but I had confidence. We have we do have Nodleaf, which helps me out greatly. It doesn't help us destroy Megastan, but it does help us against the mini bosses. I mean, with us having Mysterious Liquid, our damage is very, very good. Again, we have Lazarus' Rags as a backup, just in case. I don't think that anything bad is going to happen. We also have Game Kid on standby, in case if I do need to use invincibility, I will. Renfly going to town here. I don't know about that one. So phase two here with Mega Stanley. Another thing that you have to remember as well is because we have Nodleaf, we don't technically have to really be firing at him anymore. We could just stand next to him, but where's the fun in that? Down goes Megastan. We're going to use Game Kid just to finish him off. And that should be that. So thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed this run. If you did, click the like button. Let's see if we can get that the plus ultra streak going. Maybe we can, maybe we can't, but it would be neat to see. So I hope you all had a great start to your Saturdays here, everyone. Thank you all very much for supporting the channel. Make sure you check out Battleship coming up later on today at the 2:00 slot. And as always, we'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine, like First Name, Last Name, Cinebiz, Michael McMaster, Oliver Wendt, Josh Watson, and Mello. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode or be one of the top 5 patrons of the month, then check out my Patreon over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.